Jai Swaminarayan students, today's thought. Failure is the first step of success. That means without failure, no one can get a success. Understood? During failure, you should not broke down. So once again, today's thought is failure is the first step of success. With this thought, let's start our class today. In last class, student, we had learnt about the uses of microorganism, and one more uses is pending, that is cleanliness. That microorganism is helping in cleaning the environment. And in today's class, we are going to learn about the harmful. Before going to the topic, cleanliness, what is this doing? What the microorganism is doing in cleaning the environment? They are eating the dead and decayed, to decompose the dead and decayed matter. They are helpful and they are converted into the soil. Understood? Now we are going to move on to the next topic, that is harmful effect of microorganism. What is the harmful effect of microorganism? Main is that they are disease causing. They cause disease to human, plants, animals. Everywhere they are spreading the disease. Understood? So for the disease causing microorganisms are called as pathogens. The disease causing microorganisms are called as pathogens, and according to the disease, the diseases are of two types. One is communicable, another one is non-communicable. Communicable disease means it will spread from one person to another, like corona is spreading from one person to another. That type of disease is called communicable disease. Non-communicable disease means it will be transferred through the vectors. Vectors means the insect that carrying the disease causing pathogens are called as vectors. For example, malaria, dengue. Understand where what happens here? The malaria is spread by the female Anopheles mosquito. That they are taking the protozoa present in the body. When they are biting the human, they are that protozoa is injected in our body, and that causes disease. Malaria. Same like the dengue. Dengue is caused by the Aedes mosquito. The dengue causing organism is there in that mosquito, and then mosquito while injecting it spread into our body. Understand, students? These are the disease causing microorganisms like protozoa and Aedes mosquito spreading. These mosquitoes are spread due to the water, stagnant water. Now rainy season is there. Now there is a rainy season, so due to which the water is stagnated, in that the mosquitoes reproduce and they increase their number. Understood, student? Here in a tabular column, you can see that in the different types of diseases are given and different types of this modes are given. Understood, students? See the tabular column, students. Human disease and the causative agents, it is given. So you can refer that where tuberculosis, measles, chickenpox. Causative agent means whether it is caused by the bacteria or virus. We can say organism causing the disease. That we are seeing mode of transmission through air, water, through which it is causing. Malaria, for example, you can see that through mosquitoes. Okay, preventive measures is also given. Now let's go on to the topic of disease causing microorganism in animals. Animals, one famous disease was their anthrax. Anthrax is caused by the Bacillus anthracis. That was first discovered by, you can see that Robert Koch in 1876 discovered the anthracis. Understood? He finds the anthracis. Same like that, human may be bimari hota hai, plant, animals may be, animals also cause like that. Same like that, in plant also the microorganism causes disease. Here you can see the tabular column, citrus canker. It occurs in the citrus fruit, students, like orange, lemon, and this type of things. And bacteria causes this disease. Mode of transmission, air, rust of iron. Rust of iron means what happened? Rust of wheat means wheat ke jaisa rehta hai lekin uske andar wheat nahi hota hai. Fungi causes, air and seed. Mode of transmitter, seed ke through ho jata hai. Then yellow mosaic and bindi mein hota hai. Virus causes this, and insect is the mode of transmission. Now coming to the topic of food poisoning. Now we are going to move on to the topic of food poisoning. Food, what happens? The microorganisms present in the food make the food spoil. Understand, when we eat that food, foul smell will be, the smell will be very bad, taste will be bad. These are the symptoms of food poisoning. And what happens when we eat that food poisoning? It causes diarrhea, stomach pain, dysentery, fever. These things will occur. Understood? So next, what happens? We are doing some methods of preservation of food. That method we are calling it as food preservatives. In food preservatives, what is happening? Traditional method is the traditional method, pickles, where we use too much of sugar, too much of oil, too much of salt for murabbas. We are using too much of sugar and salt, pickles, oils we are using to protect the food. And actually two methods, I said traditional and modern methods, we are using chemicals. Understood? Apart from this, main two methods is the physical method and the chemical method. In physical method, heating, freezing, this type of means, uske layer ko hum usko physically dekh sakte ho, kya preservative. Chemical method means using chemical we are preserving. For example, wafer packets where nitrogen gas is kept. Why? Because the oil is there, because of that oil it might spread. Now you might have a doubt. Oil is there, then why it is spoiling? Here too much of oil is not there. When there is too much of oil, that will spoil. But here what happens? Here the slight oil is there. Understood, students? Next class we will learn more briefly about the microorganisms. What are the things they are? So apart from food preservatives, they are doing some other things also. How they are helping the nitrogen cycle and this nitrogen fixation, that we will see in the next class. Okay, students, and if you are having any doubt, you can contact me. Stay blessed, stay healthy. Jai Swaminarayan, Jai Bharat.